Hello friends, welcome to wifistudy.com, one-stop destination for all competitive exam. Friends, in this video, we are going to present you another section of the current affair, that is the current affair 2016, December 4th week until 2nd Jan 2017. So friends, in this video, we are going to present you the complete 4th week December current affairs and including 1st Jan and the 2nd Jan current affairs also. So friends, if you want to prepare from the application mode, you can download our Wi-Fi study app. This is a very beneficial app and you can download this app from the Google Play. So friends, if you are weak in vocabs and vocabulary and you want to prepare vocab from the pen drive course, so you can purchase our A to Z vocab pen drive course. In this, you will get SSC videos and 3000 words, 3000 vocabs. And in this video, we are giving you all the vocabs, meaning in Hindi, short tricks. We used a very, very simple trick to make this vocab easy for you. And there's the synonyms, antonyms, examples, images. And if you want to purchase this pen drive course, you can call on this number or mail us at support@wifistudy.com. And friends, if you want to prepare vocab from the application, you can download our Vocab 24 app. This is a very beneficial app. You will get a daily 10 the new words in this application, daily 10 the Hindu editorial words in this. And you will get a complete synonym, antonyms and everything you want. Okay, so you can download this app from the Google Play. So friends, if you like this video, please subscribe us so that we can provide you more videos, more content, which will definitely help you to sharp your preparation. So friends, let's start from the international section first. After that, we are going to cover national, then trade and banking, economics, appointments, everything which is relevant to your exam. We'll cover all the important current affairs of the December 4th week and the 1st and 2nd Jan current affairs also. So let's start from the international section first. World first solar road was recently opened in which country? So there is opening of the world first solar road in one of the European country. So first of all, we'll take out the news first. After that, we'll cover the answer. Okay. The world first solar road is opened in the small village of France. The 1 kilometer road was opened by the French ecology minister Royal and could generate enough electricity to power the street lights. So it is opened by the France and your answer is C, that is France. Okay. And this road is of 1 kilometer and this solar panels will generate enough electricity to power the street lights. So this is the world first solar road and it was opened by the France. So your answer is C. US President Obama signs $618 billion defense bill. So US President Barack Obama signed into law the USD $618 billion but defense budget for 2017, which enhances security cooperation with India and conditions nearly half of the funding to Pakistan on a certification that it has taken demonstrable steps against the Haqqani network. Okay, so they took some measures to enhance the security cooperation with India and also reduces the amount of funding to Pakistan on a certification that it is taken that Pakistan will take demonstrable steps against the Haqqani network. So you need to remember first of all that friend, this what is this Haqqani network? Okay, it is an insurgent group in Afghanistan. It is an insurgent group in Afghanistan led by one Sirajuddin and the Jalaluddin Haqqani. Okay, and this Haqqani network fights with the NATO forces, which is placed by the US in the Afghanistan. So that's why they provide a funding to the Pakistan to help or to take some steps against the Haqqani network so that the NATO can do their own work out there. Okay, so and also the Barack Obama enhances security cooperation with India and they want to become the India's major defense partner. Okay, they want to become the India's major defense partner. So these are the few steps taken by the Obama government and they signed nearly $618 billion defense budget. Next question. India will supply an additional dash megawatt of power to Nepal from January 1st, 2017. So India will provide some additional megawatt power to the Nepal from the new year. So what is the amount of that? So let's cover the news first. After that, we'll take out the answer. So India will supply an additional 80 megawatt of power to Nepal from 1st January, which will increase the total transmission of electricity to the neighboring nation to 400 megawatt. So India will provide 80 megawatt additional power from the new year and it will take to the total transmission of 400 megawatt. Okay. And this supply will be done by the Mirzapharpur substation in India. Mirzapharpur substation. World highest bridge open in China. So the world, the highest bridge has opened to traffic in China, connecting two provinces in the mountainous southwest and the reducing travel time by as much as 3/4. So the world highest bridge opens in China. You need to remember this. The name of the country where is the World highest bridge? This question can be asked. Now let's go to the national question. These are the some international questions that we covered, and now let's proceed towards the national question. Which is the most well-read city this year in India? Okay, so let's take out the some news from this. The national capital has emerged as the most well-read city in India for the fourth consecutive year, with Bangalore and the Mumbai taking the second and the third spot, respectively, says a survey conducted by the Amazon India. Okay, so you need to remember this. The most well-read city this year is also the national capital, that is Delhi. Delhi is the most well-read city this year also, and this and consecutively they won this prize from the last 4 years. Okay, and the second place is on Bangalore and then Mumbai. Second spot is taken by the Bangalore, and third spot is taken by Mumbai. Okay, and this survey is conducted by the Amazon India. So your answer is New Delhi. The most well-read city this year is the New Delhi. And the Chetan Bhagat book, One Indian Girl, emerged as the highest selling book of this year. Okay, so you need to remember all this also, that One Indian Girl has emerged as the highest selling book of this year, followed by the J.K. Rowling, Harry Potter and the Cursed Child, part 1 and 2. So this One Indian Girl belongs to the Chetan Bhagat. Which helpline number has been launched for consumer related grievances? Okay, so let's see the news first. The government has launched a host of online initiatives, including a mobile app, Smart Consumer, and an online consumer mediation center, OCMC, to provide speedy redressal of consumer grievances. A helpline 14404 was also launched for consumer related grievances. So 14404 is the helpline number which has been launched for consumer related grievances. So your answer is C. National Consumer Day is observed on which date? So the National Consumer Day is observed every year in India on 24th December. And the theme of this year is Alternate Consumer Disputes Redressal. Alternate Consumer Dispute Redressal. You need to remember the theme of the National Consumer Day and the date of it. So date is 24th December is observed as National Consumer Day. So your answer is B. Good Governance Day is observed on which date? So the Good Governance Day is a day of national importance in India, observed annually on 25th of December, the birth anniversary of the former Prime Minister, that is Atal Bihari Vajpayee. And the Good Governance Day was established in 2014 to honor former Prime Minister Vajpayee by fostering awareness among the Indian people of accountability in government. Okay, so first of all, NDA government want to aware that they are providing the accountability in the government. Okay, and just for that they observed, they started this Good Governance Day in 2014 on the birth anniversary of former Prime Minister Atal Bihari Vajpayee. Okay, and you need to remember the date, that is the 25th December. So your answer is C. 25th December is observed as Good Governance Day. National Kisan Divas, 23rd December, to celebrate the birthday of Chaudhary Charan Singh, former Prime Minister of India. Government in 2001 has decided to observe 23rd December every year as Kisan Divas, that is Farmer's Day. Okay, so 23rd December is observed as National Kisan Divas or Farmer's Day. Which service has been launched by the External Affairs Ministry to centralize this grievances redressal mechanism? So, expanding its social media outreach, External Affairs Ministry has launched a Twitter Seva service with an aim to centralize this grievances redressal mechanism by bringing 200 social media handles, including those of Indian Mission and regional passport officers, under one platform. So, they collaborated with the Twitter, and okay, so they will provide a grievances redressal mechanism through the Twitter. So the name of the service is Twitter Seva. Okay, that is launched by the External Affairs Ministry to centralize its grievances redressal mechanism. So your answer is Twitter Seva. That is A is your answer. So let's see another question. Which handloom helpline center will be set up by the Ministry of Textiles? So let's see the news first. The Ministry of Textiles has decided to establish a Bunkar Mitra, that is a handloom helpline center, where professional queries of weavers will be answered by the expert in the field. And this helpline will be functioned from 10 a.m. to 6 p.m. and it will be provided in 7 languages. Okay, and the 5 other regional languages. So your answer is Bunkar Mitra is named as the handloom helpline center to be set up by the Ministry of Textiles. So your answer is D. So next question, which state has launched Biju Shishu Suraksha Yojana? So the Odisha government launched the Biju Shishu Suraksha Yojana, a scheme to nurture the orphan and HIV infected children residing in the different child care institutions and orphanages. So the state government will provide the help to the orphan and the HIV infected children whom are residing in the different child care institution and the orphanages. Okay, so you need to remember the basic motive of this Yojana or the scheme, first of all. And this scheme is launched by Odisha government. Okay, so your answer is none of these. Odisha is your answer. The state government under the scheme would extend financial help for the primary and the higher education, rehabilitation, opening accounts under Sukanya Smriti Yojana, and financial help for marriage in case of girl children. The orphan and the HIV infected children would receive an annual grant of ₹40,000 per annum for pursuing higher education. So these are the few schemes which are included in this Yojana. So let's see another question. Which state has launched health insurance scheme that is Atal Amrit Abhiyan? So let's see the news first. Assam BJP-led government rolled out Atal Amrit Abhiyan health insurance scheme, which will provide coverage against several critical illness. Okay, so they will provide coverage against 437 illness in 6 disease groups. And this scheme is launched to mark the 92 birthday of former Prime Minister, that is Atal Bihari Vajpayee. So your answer is A, that is Assam. So let's see another question, friends. First second generation ethanol biorefinery in India will be set up in which state? So let's see the news first. The foundation stone laying ceremony for setting up the 2G, first 2G ethanol biorefinery in India is being held on 25th December 2016 at village Tarkhanwala, Bhatinda, Punjab, with an approximate investment of ₹600 crore. So your answer is D, that is Punjab. It will be set up in Bhatinda. Successful test flight of Agni 5. The Agni 5 is a long-range surface-to-surface ballistic missile, was successfully flight tested by DRDO from the Abdul Kalam Island, that is in Odisha. Okay, the full range test flight of the missile has further boosted the indigenous missile capabilities and deterrence level of the country. So friends, in this news, you need to remember that this Agni 5 is a, first of all, is a surface to surface ballistic missile, and it was launched by the Abdul Kalam Island. Okay, Dr. Abdul Kalam Island, and this island is in Odisha. It is in Odisha. Okay, so you need to remember this few more information. Mithun Chakravarti was a Rajya Sabha member from which party? So, actor-turned-politician Mithu Chakravarti was resigned from the Rajya Sabha citing poor health conditions, and he was nominated to the upper house by the West Bengal CM, that is Mamata Banerjee, for the TMC in Feb 2014. So he was elected by the Bengal CM, that is Mamata Banerjee, for the TMC. So your answer is C, that is TMC. So Mithu Chakravarti was a Rajya Sabha member from TMC party. Which service has been started by the railways to provide information about the delays in the train operations? So Rail Yatri has rolled out a new feature called Fog Alert to help train travelers plan their journey better in the winter. The feature allows users to check if a train is delayed due to fog. Okay, so the name of the service is Fog Alert. So your answer is A, that is Fog Alert. Which state has launched Malaria Elimination Program Daman? So the Odisha government recently decided to launch a new malaria control program, Daman, in remote tribal dominated areas. So your answer is Odisha. Odisha will start this new campaign, that is malaria elimination program, named Daman. Which state has launched 25 buses biodiesel recently? So for the first time in the country, Karnataka State Road Transport Corporation launched 25 buses that run 100% on biodiesel. The vehicles are retrofitted with the biodiesel kit with which they can run on 100% biodiesel for effective control over pollution. So your answer is Karnataka. Karnataka will going to start 25 buses, okay, by biodiesel. The Indian Army has entered into an agreement with the Daesh to set up a research and development cell on the campus. So the Indian Army has entered into an agreement with an IIT Gandhinagar to set up a R&D cell on the campus. Staffed by the faculty and the research institute, the R&D cell will attempt to solve the technical challenges faced by the Army. So they will solve technical challenges faced by the Army. So your answer is IIT Gandhinagar. Swachh Swasth Sarvatra initiative launched. So this scheme is a collaboration of the two ministries, that is, first is the Swachh, that is the Ministry of Drinking Water and Sanitation, and the second is Swasth, that is the Ministry of Health and the Family Welfare, was launched in New Delhi. So another joint initiative, that is Swachh Bachche Swasth Bharat, between the Ministry of Health and the Family Welfare and the Ministry of HRD, was also launched on the occasion. So there is a two new schemes which is launched by the two ministries. First is the Swachh Swasth Sarvatra. This scheme is a joint an initiative between the Ministry of Drinking Water and Sanitation, and second is the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, and second, that is Swasth Bachche Swasth Bharat. Okay, this is a joint initiative by the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare and the Ministry of HRD. Government suspend deemed recognition of IOA. So government has suspended the deemed recognition granted by it to the Indian Olympic Association until the IOA reserves its decision to appoint Suresh Kalmadi and Abhay Chautala as life president. So recently what IOA did, they appointed Suresh Kalmadi and the Abhay Chautala as a life president. So government want to, so sports ministry want to remove these persons as a life presidents because they are proved as a culprit in the few cases. Okay. So the government also suspended its financial and the other assistance also. Which state has signed an MOU with Andhra Pradesh to prepare citizen database? So the Haryana government has signed an MOU with the Andhra Pradesh to assist its compile a centralized database of its population to ensure efficient and effective implementation of welfare programs. Okay, so they want to prepare this citizen database because they want to implement the welfare programs by effectively. That's why they want to prepare a citizen database by Andhra Pradesh. So your answer is Haryana. Haryana signed a MOU with the Andhra Pradesh to prepare citizen database. And Andhra Pradesh already had a database of its sort. Which state has declared 50% reservation in the all judicial services for extremely backward classes, OBC, ST and SC? So the Bihar cabinet has declared 50% reservation in all judicial services for aspirants belonging to the extremely backward classes, other backward classes, scheduled tribes and scheduled caste. This reservation will be in both superior judicial services and subordinate judicial services. So your answer is Bihar. B is your answer. Which city is organizing World Bhojpuri Conference 2016? So the World Bhojpuri Conference will be begins in Varanasi. So your answer is C. And there are participants from the 18 countries to likely to be present there. During the conference, a Bhojpuri Ratna Award and the World Bhojpuri Karam Yogi Award will be conferred on over 25 people. Which state has established India's first digital investigation center? So a digital investigation training and analysis center aimed at improvising the capabilities of Haryana police in solving cyber crime cases has been set up in Gurugram, that is in Haryana. This center is the first of its kind in the country and it is set up with the help of a National Technical Research Organization, that is NTRO. And this center is established by the Haryana. So your answer is C. Arunachal Pradesh CM Pema Khandu suspends by his party PPA. So incumbent CM and the former Congress rival Pema Khandu and six other lawmakers were suspended from the PPA, that is People's Party of Arunachal, for allegedly breaking party's discipline. PPA is likely to propose the name of another leader, that is Thakam Paryo, as Mr. Khandu replacement. Supreme Court sacks Anurag Thakur, Ajay Shikre from BCCI. So the Supreme Court has sacked BCCI President Anurag Thakur and the Secretary Ajay Shikre and asked all others who were disqualified to hold post under new court mandated norms to set up. Okay, so because of the Lodha committee and reform missions, all the persons which belong to the political parties will not be able to take a seat in the sports ministry or in the BCCI basically. Okay, and this Anurag Thakur and other persons also belong to the political parties. So that's why they suspended they sacked Anurag Thakur and Ajay Shikre from BCCI. Now trade and banking. Government to launch Aadhaar payment app to simplify digital transaction. So the government is coming up with an Aadhaar payment app that could silence digital payment critics. The app is to be launched on 25 December, would also terminate the fee payment for service provided like card companies such as MasterCard or Visa. So government to launch Aadhaar payment app to simplify the digital transition. So if you have Aadhaar card, you can easily able to do the transition using this Aadhaar card. Which bank has launched Aadhaar linked cashless merchant solutions? So IDFC bank launches Aadhaar's linked cashless merchant solutions. So your answer is C. Center has through NABARD released nearly 2000 crore to dash towards the Polavaram irrigation project. Okay, so center has passed nearly 2000 crores towards the Polavaram irrigation project. Okay, so you need to remember where is this Polavaram irrigation project. So the center has through NABARD released nearby 2000 crore to Andhra Pradesh towards the Polavaram irrigation project. Okay, so it is in Andhra Pradesh. So your answer is B. Which bank has launched Bank Sakhi scheme? So Karnataka Vikas Grameen Bank launches Bank Sakhi scheme to promote and popularize cashless transition in rural areas. Okay, so your answer is A, that is Karnataka Vikas Grameen Bank. which village has been adopted by SBI to make it cashless? So India's largest lender SBI has tapped on towards a cashless economy, and as a banking behemoth has adopted a village in Maharashtra where it will drive all residents to transit digitally. Shirki, a village in the Pan Taluka in Maharashtra, is now the epicenter for SBI, which will promote Aadhaar number based merchant payment. So your answer is Shirki. C is your answer. Which bank has collaborated with Twitter for better customer experience? So ICICI Bank partners Twitter for better customer experience. So your answer is A. So ICICI Bank is the first bank in India to implement the new feature to its Twitter account for customer care. So Naidukayam Tribal Colony, which is going to be the country's first digital colony, is in which state? So the Naidukayam Tribal Colony in Malappuram district of Kerala has become the first fully digital tribal colony in the country. Okay, so Kerala is a place where this Naidukayam Tribal Colony resides. So your answer is D. Which bank has adopted Malangaon in Sangli district? So which bank has adopted Malangaon in Sangli district? So the Pune-based public sector lender bank, Bank of Maharashtra, has helped to make the village of Malangaon in Sangli district, Maharashtra, completely cashless village. Okay. So your answer is Bank of Maharashtra. B is your answer. What is the full form of BBPOU? So Mobiwing get RBI note to accept payment for utility convenience bill. So the full form of this BBPOU is Bharat Bill Payment Operating Unit. Okay, so by this only you will be able to, the Mobiwing able to provide this option of cash of payment for utility convenience bill and for other utility options also. So your answer is Bharat Bill Payment Operating Unit. So B is your answer. Which bank has launched SBI Mirror Positive app? So the South Indian Bank has introduced a full-fledged NRI-focused mobile banking application called SBI Mirror Positive across major mobile platform. So your answer is South Indian Bank. D is your answer. This SBI Mirror Way equips the customer to perform almost all banking transactions from their smartphones. Alibaba will open its first India office in which city? So Chinese e-retail giant Alibaba, which has made investment in India, Snapdeal and Paytm, is setting up its first office in India in Mumbai. The office will be located at the commercial Bandra Kurla complex in Mumbai. So your answer is A. Ajmer tops in top 5 cities in digital transaction. So after note ban, Ajmer has topped the 5 best districts to promote cashless transaction. And the PM Modi awarded scroll of honor to Ajmer collector, that is Gaurav Goyal. 4 other districts are Rajkot, Krishna, Jamshedpur and Bakaro in Jharkhand. What is the full form of Bheem app launched by the PM Modi? So the full form of the Bheem app is Bharat Interface for Money. Okay, and this scheme does not even require an internet connection. This app does not even require an internet connection since it can also work on simple feature phones. So your answer is A, that is Bharat Interface for Money. Mother Dairy unveils Aadhaar enabled payment. So to promote cashless transition, Mother Dairy Fruit and Vegetable Private Limited introduced Aadhaar enabled payment system in more than 1000 milk booth and Safal retail stores. This service will be available in addition to the existing modes like e-wallet and the smart change cards. RBI allows NRI to exchange different notes up to the June 30. So the RBI has allowed non-resident Indian to exchange scrapped rupees 500 and 1000 notes till June 30. So this facility will be available through RBI offices in Mumbai, Delhi, Chennai, Kolkata and Nagpur. Now let's see some appointments. American Tourister has appointed Dash as its brand ambassador. So the luggage maker American Tourister has appointed India's test keeper Virat Kohli as its brand ambassador. The luggage brand has signed the Ace Cricketer to feature its new integrated marketing communication campaign will be published in India, UAE and other Asian countries. So your answer is Virat Kohli. D is your answer. Pradeep Gupta has been elected as a mayor of. So the Indian American engineer has been elected as a mayor of South San Francisco City in the US state of California. With this, he became the first Indian American to be elected as a mayor of the Californian city. So your answer is South San Francisco. Who has been appointed as a DG of National Cadet Corps? So Lieutenant General Vinod Versis took over the reins of National Cadet Corps as its DG on 23rd December 2016. So your answer is Vinod Versis. So A is your answer. Who has been appointed as a new LG of Delhi? So the Anil Baijal to be the new lieutenant governor of Delhi. So your answer is Anil Baijal. A is your answer. Viral Acharya named RBI deputy governor. So Viral Acharya will be the new RBI deputy governor. Okay. And he is a 42-year-old professor at the Stern Business School of New York University. Was named as deputy governor of the RBI. Acharya, a graduate from the IIT Bombay, who had a PhD from Stern School of Business, New York University, will oversee the important monetary policy department and research. So you need to remember this name, Viral Acharya. Which country has appointed Sorin Grindeanu as a prime minister? So the Romanian president designates Grindeanu new prime minister. Okay, and he will be going to be the new Romanian head of government. So your answer is Romania. B. This Sorin is a new PM of Romania. David R. Shalim to perform duties of chairperson as a chairperson of UPSC. So president has appointed Professor David R. Shalim, Mayor, UPSC, to perform the duties of the post of chairperson, that is UPSC, with effect from the forenoon of Jan 4, 17 until the further order or until completion of a term as a member on 21-01-2018, whichever is earlier. Archana Nigam is a new Controller General of Accounts. The center has appointed Archana Nigam as the next Controller General of Accounts in the Finance Ministry. So prior to his appointment, Nigam was involved in the critical task of setting up of the accounting framework for GST regime to be launched by government in the next fiscal year. India origin appointed to be the top military post in Kyrgyzstan. So an Indian origin Saudi based entrepreneur has been appointed Major General of Kyrgyzstan, a real military position occupied by the India in the Central Asian country. Now let's see some awards. Who has been chosen for the prestigious Janpit Award for 2016? So the eminent modern Bengali poet Shankha Ghosh has been chosen for the prestigious 52 Janpit Award for 2016, the literacy organization has announced. Instituted in 1961, the award by Bharatiya Janpit recognizes Indian literates who write in one of the 22 Indian languages listed in Schedule 8 of the Indian Constitution. So you need to remember this last line, that it will be going to be provided in the 22 Indian languages listed in the 8th schedule of the Indian Constitution. Okay, so your answer is Shankha Ghosh. Who has been chosen for PETA Person of the Year Award? So actress Sunny Leon will receive PETA Person of the Year Award for his dedication to promoting the rescue of the homeless dog and cats, as well as compassion for animals abused or killed for their skin. Okay, so your answer is Sunny Leon to receive PETA Person of the Year Award. Ramanujan Prize is given in the which field? So 2016 Shastra Ramanujan Award for Mathematics was jointly presented to the Maksham Ranjivil and the Kaisa Motamaki. Okay, the award was presented during International Number Theory Conference at Kumbakonam, that is Tamil Nadu. So your answer is Mathematics. D is your answer. Who will be the awarded with the Bihari Puraskar 2016? So the Rajasthani literate Satya Narayan to be the awarded Bihari Puraskar 2016. And this has been chosen for the first for his Hindi book titled Ye Ek Duniya, published in 2010. And this Dr. Satya Narayan, his esteemed Rajasthani literature, has been honored to award the 26th Bihari Puraskar 2016 by the KK Birla Foundation. Okay. And the last year, Bhagwati Lal Vyas received this award for his Rajasthani poet collection titled Katha Sun Aave Hai Shabd. So your answer is Satya Narayan. Bhartiya Janpith announces Navlekhan Award 2016. So the two new Hindi writers, that is Shraddha and Ghanshyam, okay, has been chosen for Bhartiya Janpith 12 Navlekhan Award for the 2016, the Literature Award Organization announced. The decision to confer the award on Shraddha for his short story Hawa Mein Fadfadati Chitti and on Dash for his poem, that is Akash Mein Deh, was anonymously by a selection panel chaired by the eminent poet Vishnu Nagar. So British Indian professor knighted in a New York honor. So the Shankar Balasubramaniam, an Indian origin British professor of chemistry and a DNA expert at Cambridge University, has received a knighthood by the Queen Elizabeth II. And the Olympic star Andy Murray and the Mohammed Farah were among other awarded for their contribution. Okay, so this Andy Murray belonged to the tennis and this Farah is a long distance racer. Now let's see some sports news. Which is the FIFA team of the year? So the Argentina finished 2016 on the top of the FIFA world ranking, earning the accolade of the team of the year award, and the France has been named mover of the year award to the nation who earned the most ranking point in the last 12 months. So your answer is Argentina is selected as a FIFA team of the year. Which team has won bronze at the Women Under 18 Asia Cup Hockey? So the India take bronze at Women Under 18 Asia Cup Hockey. So your answer is India. Who has been chosen as the India Best Footballer of 2016 by AIFF? So the GJ Lalpekulia has been adjudged the 2016 Player of the Year by the All India Football Federation. Okay, the striker will get 2.5 lakh and a trophy according to the media release by AIFF. Odisha Sasmita Malik has chosen Woman Footballer of the Year and she will get rupees 2 lakh and a trophy. So friends, JJ is considered as the India's best footballer of 2016 by AIFF and the Sasmita Malik has chosen for Woman Footballer of the Year. Which team has won Under 19 Asia Cup cricket title? So India Under 19 beat Sri Lanka Under 19 to lift Youth Asia Cup title. So your answer is A. Anna Ivanovic retired recently. She was a French Open champion. Anna Ivanovic. Okay, so she belonged to the tennis. So your answer is D. Which state will host 2017 National Games? So the Meghalaya will host the 2022 National Games, which will coincide with the state 50 year of statehood. The state has pledged 5 more crore rupees as a bid amount for the game. Okay, and the upcoming National Game will be hosted by the Goa in November 2017. Okay, so your answer is Goa. Goa will organize 2017 National Game and in 2022 National Games will be going to be held in Meghalaya. Somdev announces retirement from professional tennis. So, ravaged by the injuries, India star single player Somdev Deobarman announced his retirement from professional tennis, bringing an abrupt end to what was once a promising career. Lionel Messi named the best playmaker of 2016 by AFFHS. So, Messi was won the best playmaker of 2016 award by his overall contribution to club and country by the International Federation of Football History and Statistics. Okay. So, Messi is named as the best playmaker of 2016 by 1FFHS. Now, let's see some death. George Michael passed away recently. Who he was? So, George Michael was the British pop superstar who died on 25th December. He was 53. And he sold well over 100 million albums globally. Earned numerous Grammy and the American Music Award. So, your answer is singer. D is your answer. Dinanath Bhargava passed away recently. Who he was? So, the national emblem sketcher Dinanath Bhargava passed away, who sketches the our national capital of Ashoka, Lion capital of Ashoka, and decorated the pages of the constitution manuscript, died at the age of 89 in Indore. Okay, so he was a person who sketched the national emblem, that is Lion capital of Ashoka. Okay, so your answer is painter. He was a painter. Ratnasiri Vikramasinghe passed away recently. He was a former prime minister of which country? So, veteran Sri Lanka politician Ratnasiri Vikramasinghe, who served twice as a prime minister, passed away after a brief illness. Okay. And he served twice as a PM between the 2001 and 2 and from 5 to 10. So, your answer is Sri Lanka. Former MP CM, that is Sundarlal Patwa, dies. Okay. And he was suffering a heart attack and he was 92. So, Sundarlal Patwa was a two-time CM of Madhya Pradesh. Pak oldest living test player Imtiaz Ahmed passed away. So the Pakistan cricket has lost the oldest living test player Imtiaz Ahmed after he passed away in Lahore following a protracted illness. Okay, the death of the Imtiaz leaves former batsman, that is Waqar Hasan, and you need to remember these two names, will now lives in London as a lone survivor from the Pakistani team first test tour. Okay, so this Waqar Hasan is a person who was a lone survivor from the Pakistani team first test tour. And Imtiaz was a member of the Pakistani squad that went on a maiden test tour to India. So friends, these were the international and the national news which are important for you and the relevant for the upcoming exam. So hope you like it and you will subscribe us. So friends, thank you and all the best for the upcoming exam.